Hello students, today I am going to start your new chapter, that is arithmetic progression. But before starting this topic, we need to have the knowledge of some definitions, some concepts. What are these? Sequence, progression, series, sum of series, then we will come to arithmetic progression. Now let us try to know one by one all these. What is the sequence? Sequence is an ordered arrangement of numbers according to certain rule. If you have some numbers and you have written them according to certain rule, then that is known as sequence. You can see here, I have written here this numbers, set of numbers, set of numbers. I will try to find out which set of numbers is a sequence. You can see 2, 4, 6, 8. If I ask you what type of numbers are these, you can easily identify all these are the even numbers. So there is a rule. Rule has been followed here. So yes, this is a sequence. If you see here, that you can see here which rule is here. Here it is only one time one, this three digit is written here, two times three is written here, three times three is written. So this is the rule has been followed. So yes, this is also sequence. If you see here, then identify if there is any, find out any rule has been followed in this set of numbers. It is 2, 3, 5, 7, 11. What are these? Yes, these are the prime numbers. So one rule has been followed, means a set of the prime numbers you have taken. So this is also a sequence. If you see here, it is 1, 5, 8, 7, 20, 11, 48. Any particular rule has been followed in these numbers? Try to find out. I am not able to find out any rule to write by following which rule these numbers have been written. There is no particular rule has been followed to write these numbers. Therefore, this is not a sequence. This is not a sequence. Sequence ye nahi hai. All these are sequences. All these are sequence. Ye bhi sequence hai. Ye bhi sequence hai. Ye bhi sequence hai. Ye sequence. Ye bhi sequence. Aur ye bhi sequence. I think see this. What is the sequence? It's clear to you. Now come to the progression. Actually, progression is also a sequence, but it is a particular type of sequence which is called your progression. What is that means important point which is converting the sequence to the progression? If the sequence follows certain pattern is following, then means we are able to calculate its nth term. Actually, all these are the terms. This is first term, this is the second term, this is third term, fourth term, first term, second term. So these are the terms. If we are able to find out its nth term by identifying that pattern which is used to write that sequence, then it is known as progression. Let us try to find out of these three sequences, which is a progression? Because this is not a sequence, so it is not possible for it to be a progression. Progression वही होता है जो sequence है. तो ये तीन sequences हैं. अब इनमें से progression कौन सा है? तो चलो देखते हैं. पहले मैं first वाली series sequence I'm writing. तो how? What is the pattern in this sequence? If it is a pattern, if this sequence is following any pattern, then we will try to find out that pattern. Yes, 2 is 2 into 1, 4 is 2 into 2, 6 is 2 into 3, and 2 into 4. And here is its nth term, an. I am representing its nth term by an. So first term mein 2 into 1 aa gaya, second term mein, this is first term, second term mein 2 into 2 aa gaya, third term mein 2 into 3 aa gaya, fourth term mein 2 into 4 aa gaya. To nth term mein kya hoga? 2 into n हो जाएगा, 2n. So I am able to find out its nth term by identifying the pattern which is used in this sequence. Therefore, it is a progression. So it's clear, it is a progression. Okay, it is a progression. Now come to the second one. Let us check it. Now it is 3, then 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, and this is the nth term. If you would be able to find out it's the nth term, then this sequence would be series, progression, otherwise it is only sequence, it is not a progression. In this, only one time 3 is written in A1, in A2, 2 times 3 is written, in A3, 3 times 3 is written, and in AN, how many times 3 will be written? 3, 3, 3, 3, 3. How many times it would be written? N times. If it would be written in N times, then it will be AN. If I will be asked to find out A5, then I am able to find out. Then I am able to find out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes. Randomly, if I am asked to find out any term, then I am able to find out. That's why it is a progression. Okay. Now come to third sequence. In third sequence, what is that? It is the, you know, it is the sequence of all the prime numbers written here. This is 2, 3, 5, 7, 11. Is there any particular pattern which is followed to write each and every element of this sequence? We know there is a rule, and what is that rule? That all these are prime numbers. This is the rule. But what is the pattern? There is no particular pattern. If I am asked to find out what is the seventh prime number, then I won't be able to answer by using any formula, by using any pattern. I am not able to write it. That's why it is not a progression. It is a sequence because the rule has been followed. That is the prime number. But no pattern is there to write its general term. Any term, 7th term, 8th prime number, 9th prime number, 11th prime number. No particular formula is there to find out that particular prime number. That's why it is not a progression. It is not a progression. Ye progression nahi hai. I think now the concept of the sequence and progression is very, it is clear to all of you that progression is only those particular sequences in which nth term we are able to write the nth term of the sequence. Then only it is a progression. Now what is series? See, if we write whatever the terms of the sequence, all these are sequences. If we write the sum of this sequence, then it is series. Means, agar commas lage hai, then it is a sequence. If we add these terms of the sequence, then it becomes a series. Then it is series. It is a series. This is also series. 3 plus 3, 3 plus, like this. This is also series. Means, whenever the terms of the sequences are written like this, they are added with it. Added, then these are known as series. Then sum of series, whatever will be the final answer, means the answer of these series, that will be known as the sum of series. Suppose I have a series 1, 8, 3. This is a series. Sorry, sequence. This is a sequence. And if I want to find out the sum of, if I write it like this, this is series. This is series. And now, if I write this is 16, then 16 is the sum of this series. 1 plus 3, 4 plus 5, 9 plus 7, 16. So this is the sum of the series. Now come to this arithmetic progression. If the difference of two consecutive terms in the progression is same, then it is called arithmetic progression. क्या है? ध्यान से समझिए. पहले हमने बोला सीक्वेंस आया, फिर हमारे पास प्रोग्रेशन आया, चलिए सीरीज और सम ऑफ सीरीज तो कुछ डिफरेंट ही हो गया, अब इसके बाद यहां पर आ जाइए। किस टाइप के प्रोग्रेशंस को सीरीज बोला गया, इन विच पर्टिकुलर पैटर्न इज फॉलोड एंड इन विच द nth टर्म इज वी कैन राइट द nth टर्म। नाउ व्हाट इज एपी, एपी जो है दोज प्रोग्रेशंस, वो टाइप की प्रोग्रेशन। अब इसमें फिर फर्दर क्या हो गया, स्पेसिफिकेशन हो गया, दोज टाइप ऑफ प्रोग्रेशंस इन विच द डिफरेंस ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूटिव टर्म्स रिमेन्स सेम, ओके, दैट इज नोन एज द अरिथमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन। अब हमारे पास यहाँ पर दो ही प्रोग्रेशंस है ना, तो इन्हीं दो में से देख लेते हैं कि कौन सा प्रोग्रेशन जो है अरिथमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन है। तो हमने पहले ये वाला लिखा है, दिस इज 2, 4, 6, 8, ये लिखा है आपके पास। अब ये A1 है, ये A2 है, A3, A4, ओके। अब आपने डिफरेंस ऑफ टू कॉन्सिक्यूटिव टर्म्स लेना है, A2 माइनस A1 दैट इज 4 माइनस 2 दैट इज 2, देन A3 माइनस A2, वी हैव टू टेक द डिफरेंस ऑफ ऑन दी कॉन्सिक्यूटिव टर्म्स। सो A3 इज 6 माइनस A2 इज 4, अगेन द डिफरेंस इज 2। नाउ A4 माइनस A3, A4 इज 8 माइनस A3 इज 6, सो डिफरेंस इज अगेन 2। यू कैन सी इन ऑल दीज केसेस द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीज कॉन्सिक्यूटिव टर्म्स इज सेम, दैट्स व्हाई दिस इज द अरिथमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन, दिस इज द अरिथमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन। इज इट क्लियर? नाउ कम टू द नेक्स्ट प्रोग्रेशन, दिस इज ऑल्सो अ प्रोग्रेशन, लेट अस फाइंड आउट वेदर दिस प्रोग्रेशन इज अरिथमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन और नॉट। सो दिस इज 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3 एंड सो ऑन। नाउ दिस इज A1, दिस इज A2 एंड हियर इट विल बी 1, 2, 3, 4, ओके, दिस इज A3, दिस इज A4। सो नाउ व्हाट इज A2 माइनस A1 दैट इज 33 माइनस 3 दैट इज योर 30। नाउ A3 माइनस A2 दैट इज 333 माइनस 33 दैट इज इक्वल टू 300। नाउ देर इज नो नीड टू फाइंड आउट A4 माइनस A3, बट हम चलो निकाल लेते हैं, क्यों, क्योंकि दीज टू डिफरेंसेज आर नॉट सेम, सारे डिफरेंस सेम होने चाहिए, एक भी डिफरेंस ऐसा आ जाता है विच इज नॉट सेम, देन वी से इट्स नॉट अ अर्थमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन। सो A4 माइनस A3 3333 माइनस 333, सो दिस इज 3000। यू कैन सी ऑल दीज आर नॉट सेम, दीज आर नॉट सेम, 30 इज नॉट इक्वल टू 300। Therefore, we can say the difference between the consecutive terms is not same. So, this progression is not AP. Is not AP. Nth term of an AP kya hai? Wo hai ji, AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. A kya hota hai? First term. D kya hai? Common difference. Where? A is first term of AP and N is D is common difference.
हाँ जी स्टूडेंट्स, यू हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड अबाउट द सम ऑफ द APs एंड द फॉर्मूला फॉर द सम ऑफ द AP इज एस एन इज इक्वल टू एन बाई टू 2A plus n minus 1 into d, or if you know what is the first term and the last term and also know the number of the terms whose sum you are to find out, then we can write it directly as n by 2 first term and the last term, you can do it directly also. But how this formula has come, that you have already studied in your 10th class. We will make the use of this formula directly here in this 11th class. Now next topic is, this is the sum, you can note down the formula, then your arithmetic mean. What is the arithmetic mean? Students, suppose there are two numbers A and B, and if you insert a number A in between these two numbers such that this resultant sequence becomes an AP, then this A is known as arithmetic mean. Means A, the consecutive difference between these two, A minus A, is equal to B minus A. What does it mean? Sorry, B minus A. What does it mean? This will shift to this side. So 2A is equal to B plus A. So A is equal to A plus B upon 2. So this is obtained by taking the mean, arithmetic mean of these two numbers. That's why it is called arithmetic mean. Once again, if you have been given two numbers A and B, and if you insert a number A, capital A, in between these two numbers such that the resultant sequence becomes an AP, then this number is known as arithmetic mean. This is known as arithmetic mean. हाँ जी students, अभी तो क्या था कि सिर्फ आपने A की number insert किया था A और B के बीच में. Suppose A and B are two numbers and you are inserting in between n numbers between A and B such that it becomes an AP. Then what will be the formula for these arithmetic means? All these capital A1, capital A2, all the arithmetic means which are inserted between these two given numbers to make it an AP. Okay, so now if I take, because this is an AP, so this is the first term of AP, this is the second term of AP, this is the third term of AP, and you can see if this is 1, then this is 2. Second arithmetic means the third term of AP. Then nth arithmetic means the n plus 1th term of AP, and it would be n plus 2th term, isn't it? Now what is our problem? We want to find out what is the common formula, general formula to find the arithmetic mean. For that we need to find out what is the difference, common difference first of all. Now if we suppose the common difference of this AP is D, and then this A1, capital A1, is the first arithmetic mean, that is the second term of the AP. This is the second term of AP that can be written as per the formula of nth term of AP, it would be A1 plus D. And now second arithmetic mean is the third term of AP, and that can be written as A1 plus 2D. Now similarly, if we keep on writing it like this, then it would become B, you know, that is the n plus second term. So it can be written as A1 plus n plus 2 hai, to yahan par n plus 1D aayega. So it is now B is equal to, what is the A1? A1 is A. So B is equal to A plus n plus 1 into D. So B minus A is equal to n plus 1 into D. So this implies D is equal to B minus A upon n plus 1. This is the value of D to find out the terms of arithmetic terms. Now AN, I want to find out what is the formula to find out nth arithmetic mean. So nth arithmetic mean AN is equal to AN plus 1, means n plus first term of the AP, and that can be written as A1 plus ND. Now what is A1, that is A and N, and what is the value of D? This is D minus A upon N plus 1. You need to learn only the formula of this D. This is D. And you must remember where n is equal to number of AMs inserted between A and B. ये आपको याद करना है, ये याद करने वाली बात है कि डी जो है कॉमन डिफरेंस अर्थमेटिक में कैसे निकालते हैं, दैट इज बी माइनस ए अपॉन एन प्लस वन, और उसमें एन क्या होता है, नंबर ऑफ अर्थमेटिक मीन्स विच यू हैव टू इंसर्ट बिटवीन गिवन टू नंबर्स. हाँ जी स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम स्टार्टिंग योर सम्स ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 5.1. इसमें जो पहला है क्वेश्चन दिया गया है कि फर्स्ट फाइव टर्म्स आपको लिखनी है हर सीक्वेंस की. सीक्वेंस आपको बताया था क्या होती है, सीक्वेंस जिसमें आप nth टर्म लिख सकते हैं, दैट इज़ योर सीक्वेंस. ओके, तो अभी यहाँ पर सबसे ये थर्ड क्वेश्चन मैंने लिखा है जिसमें an इज इक्वल टू 2 रेज टू पावर n है. तो a1 क्या हो गया, 2 रेज टू पावर 1, क्योंकि n की जगह 1, तो फर्स्ट टर्म इज 2. ठीक है, a2 क्या होगा, 2 रेज टू पावर 2, 4. a3, 2 रेज टू पावर 3, 8. a4, 2 रेज टू पावर 4, 16. a5, 2 रेज टू पावर 5 इज 32. सो व्हाट आर द फोर टर्म्स, 2, 4, 8, 16 एंड 32. ओके, कम टू नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, दैट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. आई हैव रिटन हियर, हियर the expression is given like this, an is equal to minus 1 raised to power n minus 1, 5 raised to power n plus 1. So what is a1? Minus 1 raised to power 1 minus 1, 5 raised to power 1 plus 1. I have replaced this n by 1. Any number minus 1 raised to power 0 means 1, 5 raised to power 2 is 25, so it is minus 25. A2 is minus 1 raised to power 2 minus 1, 5 raised to power 2 plus 1. So minus 1 raised to power 1 means minus 1, 5 raised to power 3 means 125. This is minus 125. Likewise, you can find out A3 and A4 yourself. Now come to question number 6. In this question, it is a nth term is given like this, n multiplied by n square plus 5 upon 4. So what is a1? 1 into 1 square plus 5 upon 4. This 1 square, 1 into 1 is 1, 1 square is 1 plus 5 is 6 upon 4 means 3 by 2. a2 means 2 into, this is 2 square plus 5 upon 4. It can be cancelled. So this is 2 square is 4 plus 5, 9 by 2. A3 is 3 into, n ki jagah 3 rakha aapne, 3 square plus 5 upon 4. So this is 3 into 9 plus 5, 14 by 4. It is again cancelled. 7 threes are 21 by 2. ठीक है, हाँ जी, इन दिस क्वेश्चंस यू हैव बीन गिवन nth टर्म फॉर्मूला फॉर द nth टर्म एंड यू आर टू फाइंड आउट नाइन्थ टर्म इन दिस क्वेश्चन नंबर 9. तो आपने a9 निकालना है, तो n की जगह 9 रखिए आप. a9 माइनस 1 रेज टू पावर 9 माइनस 1, 9 क्यूब माइनस 1 रेज टू पावर 8, this is 729, and minus 1 raised to power 8, because power is positive, minus 1 raised to power 8 is plus 1 into 729, means it is 729. Okay, now in this again the question is same, nth term has been given, but in this question you have to find out the 20th term. So n will be replaced by this now 20. a20 is equal to 20. 20 minus 2 upon 20 plus 3. So this is 20 into 18 upon 23. Simplify it yourself. And the students, in question number 11, you have been given first term of the sequence is 3 and the formula for the nth term of the sequence is this for all n greater than 1, sorry, this is greater than 1. Greater than 1 के लिए ये वाला फार्मूला है, और means n is equal to 1 के लिए नहीं है ये, greater than 1 के लिए. और a1 का वैल्यू यू हैव बीन ऑलरेडी गिवन. ठीक है, तो आपने निकालना है a. अब इसमें इस क्वेश्चन में फर्स्ट फाइव टर्म्स बोला निकालने के लिए, फर्स्ट टर्म तो गिवन है, सेकेंड टर्म n की जगह 2 रखिए, 3 2 माइनस 1, तो 2 माइनस 1 प्लस 2, सो दिस इज a1, व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ a1, 3, a1 इज गिवन 3, सो दिस इज 11. नाउ a3 निकालेंगे, a3, तो n की जगह आप क्या रख देंगे, आप यहाँ पर 3 रखेंगे, 3 माइनस 1 प्लस 2, दिस इज, हमने n की वैल्यू 2 से क्यों स्टार्ट की, क्योंकि इसने बोला कि n इज ग्रेटर देन 1, इसीलिए हमने n को सबसे पहले 2 रखा था, यहाँ पर 2 माइनस 1 1 आया था, ठीक है. सो दिस इज 3 माइनस 1 इज 2 प्लस 2, एंड व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ a2, दैट इज 11, वी विल मेक द यूज ऑफ दिस वैल्यू 35. लाइकवाइज a4, 3 a4 माइनस 1 प्लस 2, दिस इज a3, what is the value of a3, that is 35 plus 2, so you can calculate this and you can find out the value of a5. In this sequence you can see all the next values, next terms are depending on the previous terms, hai na. Hanji, in question number 13, a1 and a2, in dono ki value 2 given hai, इन दोनों की वैल्यू 2 गिवन है, और nth टर्म दिया हुआ है an माइनस 1 माइनस 1, बट व्हेन n इज ग्रेटर देन 2, n इज ग्रेटर देन 2 मींस 3 ऑनवर्ड्स, n की वैल्यू 3 ऑनवर्ड्स, आपको ये फॉर्मूला लगाना, तो a3 क्या होगा, 3 माइनस 1 माइनस 1, व्हाट इज दिस a2 माइनस 1, तो a3 की वैल्यू, a2 कितना है जी, 2 माइनस 1, दिस इज 1, ये a3 आ गया. a4 क्या होगा, यहाँ पर इस फॉर्मूले में वैल्यूज पुट कीजिए, a4 माइनस 1 माइनस 1, 4 माइनस 1 इज 3, a3 माइनस 1, व्हाट इज a3, दैट इज 1, सो दिस इज 1 माइनस 1 इज इक्वल टू 0. नाउ a5, पुट वैल्यू ऑफ n5 हियर इन दिस फॉर्मूला, 5 माइनस 1 माइनस 1 इज इक्वल टू, दिस इज a4, A4 minus 1, what is value of A4, that is 0, minus 1 is equal to minus 1. So first 4 terms agar dekha jaye iski, to kaun si hai, first 5 terms kaun si hai iski, A1 is 2, A2 is 2, A3 is 1, A4 is minus 1, A4 is 0, A4 is 0, A5 is minus 1, theek hai. तो ये आपकी वैल्यूज आ गई फर्स्ट 5 टर्म्स की. हाँ जी स्टूडेंट्स, 14th क्वेश्चन में a1 और a2 बोथ हैव द वैल्यू इक्वल टू 1, और an का फॉर्मूला दिया है, an माइनस 1 प्लस an माइनस 2 फॉर n ग्रेटर देन 2, n ग्रेटर देन 2 मीन्स 3 ऑनवर्ड्स, और आपको फाइंड आउट ये करना है an प्लस 1 अपॉन an फॉर n इज इक्वल टू 1 2 3 4 5. देखिए an इज इक्वल टू 1 और n इज इक्वल टू 2 के लिए तो वी हैव द वैल्यूज, है ना. अब यहाँ पर आपने a, अगर यहाँ पर 5 रखी, n की जगह 5 रखी, तो a6 आ रहा है, यानी मैक्सिमम a6 की वैल्यू निकालनी है आपने. तो पहले हम वैल्यूज निकाल लेते हैं a3 की, a4 की, a5 की एंड a6 की, ठीक है. a3 की वैल्यू, a3 की वैल्यू यहाँ के अकॉर्डिंगली 3 माइनस 1 2 हो जाएगा, प्लस 3 माइनस 2 a1 हो जाएगा, a2 प्लस a1 दोनों ही 1 है, तो 1 प्लस 1 इज इक्वल टू 2. a4 का मतलब 4 माइनस 1 3, 4 माइनस 2 2, तो यहाँ पर 3 प्लस 2. a3 कितना है 2, a2 कितना है 1, दिस इज 3, तो आप देख रहे हैं 3 है तो 2 1 है, 4 है तो 3 2, इसी तरीके से चलेगा, दिस इज 4 प्लस 3. व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ a4, 3 प्लस a 3 is 2, this is 5, A6, A5 plus A4, A5 is 5, A4 is 3, this is 8, ये हमने निकाल ली. अब हमें क्या निकालना है, an plus 1 upon an निकालना है. सबसे पहले for n is equal to 1 के लिए आप निकालेंगे, तो ये क्या आ जाएगा, 1 plus 1 2 upon a1, a2 upon a1, दोनों की वैल्यू 1 है, तो आंसर आ गया 1. फॉर n इज इक्वल टू 2, तो ये आ जाएगा a 2 प्लस 1 यानी 3 अपॉन 2 plus 1 yani 3 or A 2. A3, what is the value of A3? That is 2. And what is the value of A2? That is 1. So this is 2. For n is equal to 3. For n is equal to 3, 3 plus 1, 4 ho jayega, A4 upon A2. What is the value of A4? That is 3. And what is the value of A2? That is, sorry, here it is 4 and 3. What is the value of A3? A3 is 2. So this is 3 by 2. And likewise for n is equal to 4 and n is equal to 5, you can do it yourself. Now students, this was the last question of your exercise 5.1. Now in my next lecture, I will start your AP, sums of AP in exercise 9.2.